Welcome to VSDC Troubleshooting, Volume 6. In this tutorial, we are going to show you what to do when you get an error message while exporting your project. Tip number 1. Try changing the output folder or renaming the file. Most errors are caused by the mismatch of the output folder or the file name. Take a look at the error message. It might be that the name of one of the media files you've used in the project is the same as the project's name. And because you are trying to save them in the same folder, you are getting an error message saying that VSDC cannot replace the file it is currently using. Another option is that the folder you are trying to export your video to has limited access. To avoid this issue, we recommend running the program as an administrator or using your desktop as the final destination for the exported file. Tip number 2. Keep track of the default setting changes. Now, if the first solution isn't helpful, ask yourself, have I changed any default settings? Beyond the basic settings such as resolution, size or frame rate, there are also a few parameters that may be difficult to understand. Such parameters are encoder mode. You may get an error message saying invalid value for the selected video encoder mode, and audio bitrate. The most common error is too high frequency for the specified audio bitrate. Long story short, if you see an error message related to any of these parameters, just go back to default settings and export the file, or email us for further assistance. Tip number 3. Make sure your graphics card supports hardware acceleration for the selected codec. If you are a pro user and you have enabled hardware acceleration, just make sure your PC has the power for that. To do it, check your supplier's website. We also don't recommend changing the default hardware acceleration settings because they are optimized for the best results already. If you are sure your graphics card is powerful enough, you have not changed the default settings and you still get an error while exporting the video, shoot us an email and send us a detailed description of your issue with screenshots. We will definitely help you. And that's it! If this tutorial was helpful, give us the thumbs up and leave a comment below. See you in the next video!